I take this opportunity to thank you for being here tonight, because there's one place on planet Earth that Anthony Kenneth Knight loved. It was right here at the Cameron Brack Sports Complex. He loved the festivity. He loved the sport of soccer. He was a good member of our community and a member of the sporting enthusiasts here on Cameron Brack. And his life was well lived. He died at an early age, but at that tender age, he was able to make a distinct difference, so much so that this whole community joins in his mourning. I welcome particularly the District Commissioner, Mr. Ernie Scott, the Deputy District Commissioner, Mr. Mark Tibbetts, the Sports Director, Mr. Mitchum Sanford, and all of the sporting community here on Cameron Brack. I would like to invite the Deputy District Commissioner to share a few welcoming remarks to bring the significance of what tonight is all about. Join with me in welcoming Mr. Mark Tibbetts to share a few remarks.
Thank you, Mr. Lendon. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. It's definitely great to see each and every one of you out here this evening. I just want to welcome you on behalf of the District Commissioner, myself, the staff of District Administration, and by extension, those from the Public Works Department, in particular, Anthony Kenneth Knight, one that we, most of us, if not all, know over the years, has become known to us as Soup. And we don't say that this evening in any way disrespectful, because we all do know that that name of Soup was one that him himself cherished very, very much. And he would not have a problem with us this evening referring to him as Soup. But again, it's great to have you all out here this evening as we come together as a sporting community, just a community of with love for one that we have known for a number of years. One that many of us has come to definitely love, one that we know love this entire community and each and every one of us. We have, since Soup's untimely passing, you know, I really have spoken to a number of individuals, and none of them that you could ever hear anything negative at all. Soup was just that individual, and every time you talked with him, there was always that sense of love and respect and honor from him. And as Mr. Lendon said earlier as well, there was many things in life that gave him comfort and peace and happiness. But this particular area here at the sports field, here in the Bluff at Cameron Brack, was definitely one of his favorite, if not his favorite. I recall many times him speaking to me in regards to the field right in the back of me here, talking about how much he really loved and was definitely so appreciative of the fact that government was able to provide such a field here in this little small community. Something that, you know, we might even take for granted, but definitely is something that we need to be very, very proud of as well. And Soup was definitely proud of that. I recall him many times even saying to me, as far as his maintenance off the field at times, he didn't really care even if he was paid. He said, I don't have no problem with actually coming afterwards and during the week and even on weekends. And I can tell you, he actually did that from time to time as well. So again, he just showed his love there. Just want to take this opportunity, in addition to just welcoming each and every one of you here this evening, but just to say special condolences to his family and maybe close friends that are here with us this evening. Many of us feel your hurt, feel your pain. And as I'm reminded right now of a famous quote by Colin Parks, who once said that grief is the price that we pay for love. So just reminding you of that this evening, but again, thankful for that you could come out here and be with us as we pay our respects to Soup, and we trust will be a most enjoyable evening here, although it's not for the best of reasons, but definitely one that we can still feel proud that we're out here and showing our respect for someone that we definitely love in this community. But again, thank you all. Please do enjoy the rest of the evening. And for Soup, again, may his soul rest in peace. God bless you all.
In our normal Cameron Bright fashion, it would not be appropriate to start such an event without invoking the presence of Almighty God himself. To do so, one of Soup's colleagues will join me in leading in a word of prayer. I'm asking out of reverence for those who are able to stand, to please stand as we go to the Lord in prayer.
What? Can you please stand? Well, let's pray. Oh God and our Father, we thank thee for today. We thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you for brought us through the day, dear God. Dear God, we thank you for the presence of our people who come together to mourn the life of our lost brother. But God, you declare in your word, when one is gone, he is free of all pain and all his troubles. So I pray, God, at this moment, you may comfort those that are mourning. Dear God, we thank you for your mercy and your grace, that you spare us, that we have life, that we could come here to mourn the life of our brothers. And we thank you for each and every one of us, the Public Works Department, DEH, the leader, the members of government, and everybody that is here tonight, God. We thank you, and we ask that you would just guide us and protect us as we gather here tonight. And whatever we do, dear God, we may recognize that you are God and you are worthy to be praised, and we recognize you and we thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Thank you, you may be seated. The procedure that will follow tonight, and for those of you who knew Soup when it came to this game, for this field, it was about order and discipline. He enjoyed participating as a referee. And tonight, we're going to follow procedure by starting off tonight with a moment of silence in reverence and in respect for the man who devoted so much of his time and effort to this sport. You will be signaled for this moment of silence with the blowing of the horn from the trump. At that time, we'll commence the moment of silence, and it will end with a double blow of the trump. Following the moment of silence, we're going to ask all who are able to join with us to walk around, to do a loop around the track with our lit balloons. We will have those who are involved in reffing, coaching, to line up in the middle of the field with their balloons. Once the loop is around, and works manager Justin Borden will lead, and I'm asking you just to follow his lead as he distributes you at different locations around the field. As we illuminate this field in representation of the illumination that Anthony Tooney Knight Soup brought to this field when he came out with his smile and the pride that he brought on to the, I always admired when he walked, the neatness that he walked with his uniform, the dignity, the pride he held. And tonight we will walk around here, create a loop, and at the time when you're signaled by one of his close colleagues, one of his close sports enthusiasts, who will be driving Big Red over here, the vehicle that Tony drove to groom this field, he will drive it up and down, but he will receive a whistle blow from Tony's mentor who joined football with him 30 odd years ago, Mr. Mitchum Sanford, will blow the whistle when a ball will be kicked by Lil Ray, Raymond Halston, and all who hold the balloons on the sideline will toss the balloons inward to the field. When the ball hits the ground, that's the signal. When the ball that Lil Ray kicks off hits the ground, you will toss the balloons in. There will be a whistle blow representing that time. When the balloons are tossed in, you can dribble the balloons. And the center line will toss the balloons in the air. Ladies and gentlemen, I am now going to ask you to join with me to stand again as we go to our minute of silence, represented as we start with the blowing of the horn. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for the moment of silence and respect for Anthony Kenneth Knight. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ask you to make your way onto the field with your balloons and follow the lead of Mr. Justin. I want to warn you that the lights will be going off momentarily. We're simply giving you time to make your way to the field. Illuminate this field as the smile of our fallen brethren, Anthony Kenneth Knight, illuminated it so many times. We ask you to monitor your steps carefully in the dark. Thank you.
And Everyone is positioned around the field. The field looks beautiful as we come here tonight to remember our soup. State Coach Mitchum Sanford will give us a whistle. Raymond Holston will kick the ball in his normal, strong fashion. All below starts in with dribble. We can all imagine Tony smiling at us, enjoying, reveling in this celebration. Ladies and gentlemen, take this opportunity just to reflect on your own memories with Tony, with Soup. Share with each other your comments, your memories, your reflections about our brethren. I thank each and every one of you. I give a special thanks to some of our soccer players that he had such an influence on. I see Brian, I see Steven, I see Cameron, all that worked along with him. Ladies and gentlemen, the Kim and Brack Sports Complex is a very monumental achievement for this community. And look at where you're standing here tonight. I know for a lot of us, and I include myself into that equation, this is the first time for many of us that have made it to this field. Let's not make it be the last time. And I am sure if we can achieve that, that would be making Tony's effort of elevating sports on Cameron Brack, special soccer, and pushing and promoting the Cameron Brack Sports Complex. It has been a beautiful night, and one that will go down in memories, and I thank Mr. James Tibbetts for being here, who will capture this moment, and I'm sure he will share it with us on Facebook, Instagram, and anywhere else. Beautiful night. I thank you. I would like to thank the works manager, the HR manager, for district admin, the district commissioner, the deputy district commissioner, and DEH for all coming together and making this event possible to respect and celebrate the life of Anthony Kenneth Knight Soup. Tomorrow, we will lay his body to rest at 2 o'clock at the Ashton Ruddy Center. I'm also asking you to come out there to show our respect and reverence for Tony in his last passage on to
the other level. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you. Do not feel rushed or compelled. This is a time for us to fellowship about our brethren. Enjoy your time at the Kevin Rock Sports Complex on the football field. Soup! And you see the picture of him crossing his heart because of his love for the game. Ladies and gentlemen, you all would know Tony was our operator, truck driver at Public Works Department. One of our trucks is here tonight to represent him. He drove the grooming machine that is here called Big Red, and he, for 10 years, drove the DEH garbage truck that is here. The trucks will be making a loop around the track. Please be careful when you're crossing the track. Watch out for the truck passing. Thank you.
coming up.